Hello everyone, this is SB Architect. Today I want to do something interesting, which it will be peeled facade. This is a some kind of unusual effect that you cannot find similar around you, but when it comes to doing that in ARCHICAD, it may be a challenge. If there is a challenge in ARCHICAD, SB Architect will be there. Let's cut to the chase, but before we get started, I would just like to ask you to like this tutorial because it's going to help this channel to growing up, and I suggest you to subscribe because I'm gonna make similar tutorials. So let's get right into that. Alright, the first thing I'm going to do is, as usual, I change the working units first to the centimeter to make that easier, and after that I'm gonna build a simple building because we need a building to place that peeled facade. Okay, let's go to rectangular one from here, and for the structure let's make it simple, maybe like this. There we go. And wall thickness isn't important, but I changed it anyway. Okay, maybe it will be 3 or 4 story level building, so I'm going to attach that to the story 2, or maybe we can add one more here. Insert above, click OK, go to ground floor again, and from here let's select this third story. Once we have this, we can add a quick door onto that. Control plus T, and here we have entrance door, metal doors. Let's go with this double door, click OK and place here, and F3 to 3D. There we go. I think this will be a convenient building for this tutorial, but I'm gonna add a terrace on that anyway. Of course, for the structure, let's make it simple. And I'm gonna change this elevation to 100 cm down. Alright. Now, once we have this, to make that peeled facade, I'm gonna go to ground floor. And I'm just going to use the morph tool, but we are going to use this morph a bit different. I'm going to make a profile on this ground floor and also first story to the second story. After that, I'm going to connect them together and assign their edges a proper curve. After doing a decent shape, I'm gonna add lines with edges. So once we are in the ground floor, we are going to select this polygonal, and we are going to start this right corner straight through here. And after that, I'm gonna use this second or third curve edge and make our first peeled move. There we go. This is the first one. Once we have this, I'm going to copy this, Ctrl plus C, and go to first story, Ctrl plus V, and also to the second story. Paste it again, and also to the third story. Now we can go to 3D. Here we can see our peeled facade skeleton. This part will seems like this, but this is going to be different. I want this part peeled from this corner. To do that, first let's isolate our morphs in the 3D. So let's alt click N of this with Ctrl plus A and hit the F5. And I'm going to first connect these together. So create another morph like this one. And here after that, I'm going to determine the extended space with another morph. This is going to be our field space. Maybe it's going to be 150. And now we are going to connect this together. And in order to make this straight line to change the curve, let's click this edge and click the second curve edge. And from this side, I am going to determine the edge position. And also the same thing happens here. Maybe we can connect them. Oops, I've made a mistake here. Let's delete. Okay, here we can see this intersection symbol at the cursor. And now let's click the curve again and from the top view. Let's make another curve like this. Now at this part, I'm going to change this end corner position with this move node to this corner point. And I'm going to get rid of this one. And now at this stage, we are going to fulfill these morphs with some surface. So first, let's get rid of this editing plane display, and I'm going to select them all, right click, and from Boolean operations click union. Now this is one piece, which means we can assign some faces from design menu, modify morph and cover with faces, and I'm going to click this smooth surface. Because here in this part we need some smooth surface, which is going to be using smooth surface will be better. Click OK. Here we have a problem. Okay, to solve that, I'm going to try to remove this interior edges. By the way, to select any specific morph element, you just hit Ctrl plus Shift and click any part you want, like so. And let's try again. Design, modify morph, cover with first surface faces, smooth surface, and click OK. This is a bit more better. But we have some shading problems. To fix this problem, I'm going to try something else. I'm going to click this edge and copy along to morph shape, maybe to here, and maybe. But it's not working anyway. Ctrl plus Z. So let's make this again. Ctrl plus Z, and I'm going to get rid of these three pieces of edges, and I'm going to create another one segmented line. And also as for this edge. With Ctrl plus Shift after select that and hit delete and click this corner and click this straight segment and complete the shape. Now we are going to fulfill with cover with faces. Okay. Now as you can see, we have very nice smoothing peeled facade from the left part, and we have also here, but we have also a shading problem. To fix that, I'm trying to something else from this edge type. I'm going to click this edge type sort and apply changes to custom. Click OK. There we go. Now this is looks far away better. Hit F5 again. And let's make a 1 centimeter distance from building. Okay. But as you can see here, this is one face surface. If you make this, or if you create a make a thickness or make this solid, we are going to duplicate this to here and connect them together from the edges. But generally, when it comes to create some solid element from a simple face, the construction order works like this. But make this make a simple one if I can do. Editing plane is a working different. Let's activate that from editing plane display and click this one and make horizontal. Okay. Let's make a simple face and we just click this face and here we have push pull and we've made that solid. But when it comes to make this something like this, we don't have any push pull options here. We are going to make this manually. So let's hit F5 with that and copy maybe 5 centimeters. Because I would like to give that 5 centimeter thickness and I'm going to union them. After that, click this corner and click this pencil and go to simple line and connect them together. And also as for this corner. Here you can see the face was automatically created. And also same thing here. There we go. And also same thing goes here. Alright. Now this is a solid element. As for the final step, we are going to create opening for that door. One of the easiest way of doing that, we can presume that that door has some eaves on that. So let's model a simple eaves for that door. Maybe like so. And after that, I'm going to make some boolean operation. Right click, connect and solid element operation. Click add as operator and as target for our morph. And subtraction with downward extrusion, hit execute. There we go. Now it's time to align them together. And also this corner, if I can. Alright, maybe upper elevation. That seems some face here, so I'm going to push it to inside with another 5 centimeters. maybe we can change its thickness and also elevation. All right. And of course we can change its material. It's no matter at this stage. Okay, here we go. And I'm going to make this brick. We can fix that by moving this morph a little front. Maybe another 3 centimeters. Okay, there we go. All right, that's all it for this tutorial. I hope you have learned something new. I'm going to add my Patreon link into the description where you can download all of my ArchiCAD project files as well as this one, for example. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.